Everybody, we're the Chrises, and I wanted to give a little explanation of the problem of calling a plural system a system, or a multiple system a system. A system is a very broad definition. It's a both scientific and engineering type of term. It's used in systems theory, and this is basically the best combined definition that I could come up with that explains some very key points that I underlined. This was going to be a slide for my presentation this coming February in Orlando when I'm at Healing Together conference. I'm sorry, I'm dog sitting and the dog is ramming me with the collar of shame. Yes. Can you go somewhere, lay down? Anyway, he's kind of a juggernaut. He just like rams into you. So to define a system is a set of connected elements, which can consist of subsystems, members, entities, factors, parts, boundaries, forming a complex whole organized for a common purpose, nested in and influenced by a larger surrounding system. So what does this mean? Well, let's go to slide number 2 and I will explain. So here on slide number 2, we are featuring a single system inside the purple boundary, any kind of system. This is not just a plural system or any specific kind of system. This is describing the whole concept that we had in the former slide as what a system is. So a system here, you can see, has a boundary separating it from the outer system, and that boundary also separates it from these other two systems off on the sides. Now, if you're looking in terms of the outer system, these are three subsystems of the outer system. And I put some ideas of what this primary system in the middle here could be. So it can have an environmental outer system, and then there's the system itself. And inside of it, you can see, so here we've got a subsystem within the larger system. And then we have two neighboring systems, we'll say, two influential systems, or systems that are passing either raw materials, information, anything. Okay, so systems have within the system, so within system we have shared resources, we have things that the subsystems within the system are sharing in between the members of the system. So these are all members within the system. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. In terms of a plural system, these members would be entities. They'd be the people inside of their head. We'd have Buck and Star and Aliessa and whoever else, you know. So we have all of the people in the system. And then we have a subsystem, right, like this, and that's the Christinas, and so on. All right, so we have different things going on within the system itself, and then we have communication or commerce between other systems. So if I call my therapist, I'm having a communication, an exchange of information with an external system. Now, here's where it gets fun. Okay, this is not limited by any means to plurals. Okay, this can be, over here, this could be a singular system. Well, then what's this, you might say? Well, that would be that singular system's subsystems, whether, I just let him out, so he's just whining at the door, just cause. I really did just take him out. So, the singular person has, say, interrelated belief system, sensory systems, physical systems, like their... I just took you out. You go and wait a minute. So they have their digestive system, their belief system, their circulatory system, etc., and all of the different things that they do. They traffic information and resources around inside of the system. You take in food, that's a resource, and it becomes a resource for the system, right? So that could be a singular system. And maybe this is an OSDD system, and this is a plural system. Whatever, right? Or maybe we're not even in plural universe. It could be politics. This is the United States political system, and it's influenced by Canada, or it's influenced, if you look at the three different, the United States has three different systems. You've got the executive branch of government, that's its own system. The judicial branch of government is its own system. And they have influence on each other, and they have commerce, and things pass in between them. And they have boundaries that they need to defend from whatever else. You know, they need to moderate the amount of influence they have on each other. That's what the boundary is. The boundary separates either physical, spatial things or temporal things, or you have boundaries between your belief system and your morals or your ethics. So this is kind of like a diagram explaining different things about system theory. Okay, so all of us are very familiar with school systems. That's a great way of explaining a system. So your school system includes the boundary, which is the actual physical grounds of the school in question, right? So you have your school and you have the school grounds, and or you have the whole school system, and then you have the elementary school itself and so on. So each of those schools is a subsystem within the larger school district. Then you have commerce between the outside system, which is the community, and into the school system, which is like the children or the teachers who go in and out of the system and pass through the boundary. And then you have the information and resources being exchanged. So you have the Cisco truck, which is a company that does bulk food management, that drives up and brings the school lunches to the school. And then you have the staff that takes them, transforms them into, let's say, a hot lunch or a ready-to-eat lunch, and then gives them to the students, who then digest them and hopefully leave the remains at home. but anyway, so you have different types of systems that all have these rules. These are actual like laws of systems, or how systems interact. It's a set of connected elements forming a complex whole. So in terms of, let's go back to a plural system. All right, so we'll just for the moment talk about plural systems. You're all connected. You're all part of a complex whole, like a group entity. Right? You can call yourselves members of the system, entities of the system. Your body is the boundary. And organized, hopefully organized, and that's a lot of the work that I do on internal community. And hopefully you have a common purpose. Again, that goes back to the work I do on internal community. And then nested in and influenced by a larger surrounding system, which is what we call either human space, or external reality. I'm not being neat at the moment. My iPad is standing up, so it's a little awkward. Let me put it down so that I can be less awkward. And So we got human space or external reality, or you could say maybe right now it's your house or the neighborhood, community, the city or the state, etc. It can also be a family system, which is different than an internal family system. If you have a MSW or licensed MSW as your therapist, then they probably think very much about family systems. You may be in school, so you may have a school system outside of your plural space, etc. You know, I don't have to go through all of them, but you get the idea. So these are also systems that surround us. These are influencing, okay, and we exchange elements with the larger surrounding system. And if we don't, we wouldn't still be here, because that's where we get our food and our internet connections and everything else is from that external reality or human space. We exchange, say, money in exchange for our cell phone connection and things like that. So that is our external surrounding system for a plural system. So hopefully you find this helpful and maybe helps you understand why, you know, I go into this more in my whole presentation, but I don't want to take that long now. And of course, I need to be able to give my presentation. But I do go into this kind of to this degree for the bigger presentation. And then go into why it is that people need help basically becoming an organized system with a common purpose and getting along with their larger surrounding system, and so on. So that's kind of like the total 101 intro to system theory. System theory. Because it's complicated, and because there's probably more to it than I'm explaining, and I am not a scientist, a theoretician, or an engineer. So that is my layperson example of system theory. There you go.